sometimes school buses will move. Hence, it is essential if you have only a single lane, the width should be equal to 3.5 to 3.75 meters. Two lane is a multiple of that, three lane again is a multiple, four lane like that. So this is what we have to practice. Many times we squeeze the road width. The right of way is nothing but the road in front of us, the carriageway, what I said earlier now, the footpath, the shoulder, plus a drainage and some reserve land like that. So in general, any development authorities of the entire country, they try to follow 9-meter road width, right of way, 12 meter, 15, 18, 20, 24, 30, 45, 16, and 90 or 100 like that. That's what the road has this hierarchy. So the road hierarchy should be taken into place properly and also adequate footpath better provide for the pedestrian. Unfortunately, considering the car traffic and vehicle movement, at the cost of pedestrians, we reduce the footpath in the name of road widening, which is unfortunately happening in India. So this is a typical cross-section one has to follow the inside or outside. We have to give a good gradient for drainage also, otherwise road gets spoiled. So we have to give good the cross slopes and which are good drainage.